now, we switch on to another segment entirely. Chamberlain and I are not anchoring here. We have two new anchors just for today, just for 30 minutes, and you can see they are already smiling. Akwidolo Rewogene is with us, as well as Baigun Oluwatoyin. Akwidolo is Forever, and Baigun Oluwatoyin is Woli.
Well, I know you're not anchoring, that's why you're going there.
But yeah, go ahead. Exactly.
I can see that.
Welcome, anchors. My co-host.
Yes. Welcome, the guest.
Continue to anchor now.
So, since you are anchoring, so yes. How has been 2019?
Yeah, exactly. I want the plan for 2020.
Yeah. Don't let me answer 2019 first.
No, you. We should be asking
should
you.
Should he start from 2016, in fact?
No, that's too far. You know, these days you go to church, and somebody wants to give a testimony, and then she starts like, in 1979, when God, and the man of God is like, wait, mother, we don't have time. Start from 2019. Because only God knows what he did for you in 1979. Start from the current one.
You said we shouldn't eat a certain kinds of rice at Christmas. Why?
Because basically, I believe that the rice meant for Christmas is white rice and stew. And fowl.
Which research?
No, sir. I take these things very personal. White rice and if you are talking about you cook fried rice on Christmas Day, it's Angel Gabriel's birthday that you celebrated. If you cook your love rice, it's in Jamaica. Jesus Christ's birthday, white rice and stew. And fowl. I didn't say chicken, fowl. Chicken is frozen chicken. Fowl is the one that you cut the neck and throw inside hot water and peel the feather. Yeah. That's the fowl that stress you to fry. Mm. That's Christmas food.
But so, people who made fried rice,
they will do another Christmas.
Which day?
They would just choose any day. Because what they did was Boxing Day.
So how did you spend your own Christmas?
You know, I was on the mountain as a prophet. You know, I see a lot of visions. I was sitting there. I saw something for you. You know, yeah. These are deep spiritual matters. You get, I praying about the nation Nigeria. You know, I got clear revelation.
What did you see for him?
You see what I saw for you, sir. You've not seen anything yet. Ogami, Wobi, Joe, Maleni, look at me. I'm not your mate spiritually. Look at me. Hold on. I see you changing your tie. Normally, you know, I know you. You're a presenter.
But
you
I change that every morning.
No, I see another tie for you. I see something like tie bow. It's different from bow tie. They tie from the neck forward. I saw something.
It's not the most. I know what that was.
No, when you wear
it, he said he went to the mountain.
No, when you wear a seen tie, now you might even seen tie and die.
No, that's why I don't want that type. I don't want to die.
You saw a vision for Nigeria.
You see, 2020 is very strategic. Listen attentively. I'm here to just release words. In fact, there's somebody watching at home. His name is Kunle. He stays in Korodu, but his destiny is on the island. Now, he needs to track it. They don't call spiritual tracker. These are things revealed to us only by... I'm too deep. People can't comprehend. What I can... I've saw for you too. What I carry is heavy. Now, what did I see for you? They are charging your glory. Now, for I can't locate the charger. You see, there are deep spiritual things. There are deep spiritual things that only can be conveyed. On the 23rd, I saw a revelation of areas where you pray and answer prayers quickly. Now, if you stay on Banana Island, listen, Nikon eating, listen, those areas, Pinnock Estate, if before you kneel down, God answer in 5 minutes. That's it, quickly. Now, if Bejuleki down to Ekpe, your own is 1 week because of the area. Now, by the time you are coming to Woroshoki,
spiritual network,
because some areas don't need generator. Now, by the time you are coming to the mainland, you are in a serious issue. Now, listen to this. Ekbeda down, Alakuko, down all those areas. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, 2 weeks. The same prayer request. Now, let me shock you. Ikorodu, precisely. You are using a month. Now, by the time you are entering Moweba, I saw you. You need to hard fast into it because you are between Lagos and Ogun State. You see, these are deep spiritual matters.
What of Markwe, who is in Abuja?
Yes,
Abuja! Abuja, listen attentively. They are praying on your behalf. That's what I heard. That's
the... As the people pray.
They are praying because it's intercession. That area is FCT. They intercede for you. If you are staying in Songwater, down those areas, don't worry. Just branch to Shiloh. Go and do your own intercession. See, these are deep stuff.
You said you get him. What do you get?
No. I get him when you talked when you spoke about Ikorodu. Ikorodu. Yeah, because when I first came to Lagos, God will judge that boy. He deceived me. I said I need a house of my own. He said there are good houses at Ikorodu. So he took me to Ikorodu around 12 o'clock in the afternoon. So the road was free. And I said, there's even no traffic on this side. He said, yes, so I didn't know that the people that caught the traffic have not closed for work. I now saw a house, and I paid. 72,000, I can't forget that rent. And because I came from Enugu to Lagos, called my friend that lives in Lagos. I said, my brother, I've gotten a house in Lagos. So he said, so quick, 1 week? I said, yes. He said, where? I said, Ikorodu. He said, my friend, you just went back to the east. I didn't understand until the following morning. Got to the bus stop, a Greek bus stop, by 8 o'clock. Bus was full by 10, we've not moved. I asked the man, I said, okay, what's causing traffic today? He said, okay, it's not today, it's every day. I said, so where's the alternative route to... He said, we have to go through Sagamu. I said, I'm not going to arrest, all your time I'm going to. He said, be patient. He now asked me. I told him that before I came to Lagos, I saw Toto buildings, Advert. I said, what are those buildings? He said, ah, they're not on this side. I said, I don't understand. He said, Lagos have two parts. Island and mainland. I said, what's the difference? He said, island is for rich people. And mainland is for upcoming rich people. I said, so where are we? He said, we're on other lands. I said, so we're not even close to. I said, eh? I said, so. He now said, how much is your house rent? I said, 72,000. He said, your mind told you that you're in Lagos. I said, I don't understand. He said, Lagos rent begins from 250. I said, so where are we? He said, what did you put the extension? So when he said people in Ikorodu that prayer is 1 month, it's not actually 1 month, it's 1 month, 1 week. It's not it's the new 20.
There are deep things people don't know.
Yes, sir.
One of the greatest things, but thank God I ever had was some few months back. I spoke to God and have relocated. Now, the issue is not that I'm a tenant. No, that's not the issue. The issue is the fact that I did not know how they did it. How can they create WhatsApp group for tenant and they made me admin? I felt it. That was an insult on my anointing.
It means you can never pack.
You make me an admin.
You can never leave that company. That's what I'm telling you. You are the co-landlord, but that still pays rent.
He will not be texting it on WhatsApp. We'll go and huff. I said, no, father, reverse this. This can't be the issue. I'm seeing a vision to somebody in Abuja. There's a lady in Abuja. Abuja Studio of Shanice.
What is she wearing?
I'm seeing her something black jacket.
My
on
brother,
top.
All of us are seeing her.
No, I'm seeing.
All of us
I'm
are seeing her. She's on TV. The whole world is seeing this vision you are seeing.
Vision for. She has this very nice car that she uses. I don't know if she can sew as a seed.
It cannot be. Best they receive the car when you want to.
Yes, can you choose?
Is that the vision you saw?
Yeah, can she sew something?
I really.
If she sew something. What would she use then?
No, for a while. You know, it's just a test of faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for. Evidence, my fish awada. Evidence, my fish of things not seen. Surely, we've prayed. I don't know. I just
said, so why isn't the one that is seen the car? Why don't you use the one that you haven't seen?
I don't know. There's something about you. Something strange. Look at your hand. You have a wristwatch. Look at my hand. No wristwatch. What is something telling you?
I should go and pray more.
I love him. Oh, I know him.
Now, when you were young.
Yeah.
And now that you are old, difference between this Christmas celebration?
Oh God, yeah. There are a lot of difference. Now, first of all, I realized something. Now that I'm old, where I came from, Ibadan precisely, is called Babakeresi. It's not Father Christmas is advanced for people like it. It's called Father Christmas.
No, don't reduce me. Mine is not Father Christmas. Mine is Santa Claus. I know, so I'm not suffered like you, so don't bring me to your level.
So I realized that, first of all, the gift has changed. Before, Father Christmas, big gift. In 2019, I'm shocked. Something black like long, small, pulley bag. What is happening? Before, like it's talk about the fowl. You see, the fowl we had then, you get my point, sir? As the last born of the house, you are the one that will kill the fowl. You are the one that will boil hot water. You are the one that will put the fowl inside hot water, remove the feather. You are hoping that something good will come out. You will separate the middle.
Then
your mother will say, don't let Ororo break inside.
That bitter thing.
There is the bitter thing. At the end of your stress, you are hoping and praying. They give you that leg thing that's like this.
That's
something clawish.
That's a zanku.
They tie it to the neck.
Yes, God bless. Then your mother will not say, sorry, oh mommy, don't be angry. You are going to eat a fleshy part. What are you hoping for? Something wing-like or something lappy? No, it's the head, not even the head. That thing, they just cut it. They say that's the fleshy part. But it has advanced now.
Wow, wow, wow.
How is your home?
Wow. I feel sorry for your brain. Well, our own then, there's all Christmas Eve. It's when I got to Lagos, I know that it was called Christmas Eve. New Gale, we're calling it Wash Night. So we go to get bamboo sticks, we build a house. So it's our Christmas house for the children. We just go there, play, and then that fowl, very important.
Very fowl.
You now key fowl, and then there's one gizzard inside the stomach that has sand. You will not tear it open and remove the upper layer.
Then, if you are from a rapper, they will do, I think they are consulting oracle. My mother will say, don't worry, the chicken might wake up again. Now we have
And then, our parents will now buy Christmas clothes for you. Then on Christmas Day, you will now walk the money of the cloth back. You don't know. You thought it was visitation. They will send to go and visit all your uncles, and they will dash you money. Is your Christmas clothes you are walking back? Because if you don't walk it back, that means you don't have school fees for next term. So you will not visit everybody. You will not trek. You will not see children. You will not look like admin of WhatsApp group. All of them wear the same color. Trek and greet both uncles. You now get to ask, you say, Uncle, I don't need to go. And say, when you reach out, greet your mama. I said, no, but wait till they tell us. So they say, we'll go and I will give us something. So you walk it back, you come back, you are exhausted. But for me, it was beautiful because families were together. Yeah. Unlike nowadays, everybody were very selfish. Your Christmas is at your house. You buy one fowl. Why? In those days, you buy four because you are expecting people to come and visit you.
Of course, definitely.
Now you stay inside your house, you buy one fowl, and even bachelors are suffering. Before in the compound, Maibo will cook and give to the bachelors in the compound.
Yes.
Right now, for a bachelor, for you to eat Christmas, you have to contribute to. Before I got married, my neighbors have to buy onions. I say, see my contribution. No. If you don't buy onions, you'll just be licking scent. You perceive scent, lick, then drink water.
Then our Karo song too, different. Yeah. You know, are from indigenous part of Nigeria, Yoruba precisely. You know, not this Ajin Abida leader. No.
What's that? Wait, what's Abida leader?
I thought it's foreign one.
No, even that's not foreign. So that's even local. What? The foreign one is not Abida leader. Felix. Repeat after me, Felix.
Felix.
I didn't say Felix. Felix.
Please, I'm Obama. Don't embarrass me. Felix.
Navidad. And I mean Navidad.
Then we see Abiyo Lugbala Konfuwa. You know the fella, you know. Ni Lu Bethlehem. Eni Tio Jobaye. Ayiraye. Our city, Ira Wore, Ira was something come, you know, the parachute thing, the church drama, William and Joseph. Something very interesting. But right about now, what are we seeing?
Gentlemen, give us your experience about the comedy industry. I mean, you know that, is it growing? Do people find time to come and watch comedy? Is it something that, you know, of course, yes, people need to relax once in a while and that, but how's the industry?
So the industry is growing, all thanks to Alibaba for, like I say, it's my employer of labor. Yeah, because if he didn't do this, I don't think I might have had in mind.
Did he give you minimum wage?
No. The minimum wage he gave to us was to believe that this thing is possible. So that was basic. So it's growing right now, but I still think a lot of Nigerians still don't place value on it because it's not tangible. So for example, you go to the mall to get this glass.
Yeah.
You know that this is what you're getting. So when you ask how much is this, and then they tell you the price, you don't even argue, you just pay for it because you can actually see what you are buying. So you tell these guys, forever, how much do you charge? And then you call a fee, and they're like, not be just to talk. I have to ask one woman about that. If it's to talk, why are you looking for me to help? Can't you talk? So for them, it's not tangible. So basically, true life experience, when I was in Enugu, somebody called me for an event, and the man said, forever, how much do you charge? So I told the man then, 100,000. And the man asked me, are you coming with the whore? I said, I don't understand. I said, that's the exact price of the whore. And you will be inside. You are charging the same price with whore that everybody will sit inside. You know, ask me, do you have respect for cement? So, but there are certain few people who understand that, okay, well, It's value that we're adding to their event. And that's what we want all Nigerians to get to, where if you cannot afford this particular brand, there is someone else who you can afford. But don't talk down on it because you cannot afford it. Because in their mind, they cannot see it. You tell the joke and it's gone. After the event, you know, you go for a wedding, you are eating rice. You are seeing the rice that you are eating. The meat you are eating is stressing you. So in your mind, hey, I paid for this one. But you can't hold the joke. You all laugh. After the event, you might never remember the joke. You say, so that money don't go like this. So
is that your own experience?
For me, I feel the subject of comedy is quite diverse. You know, there is stand-up comedy. There is the kind of comedy that people do in movies as well. So it depends on the genre. But generally, I feel that it's getting more open because of the advent of social media. The media now made another emergence of some creative guys that do skits and make people happy. And what has that done? I call it that's giving you, you know, comedy per view wherever you are. That means you can be on your phone and watch a particular skit, either on Facebook. Now, the shareability is now much more. So people can just create content. You know? So they call them content providers. So that means you don't need to have a 5,000 naira to sit at a hotel before you can actually enjoy humor. You can wake up at midnight and just go to your phone and enjoy variety of this guy doing amazing stuff. And I feel it's a completion to the whole process. There are some stand-up comedians that do the stand-up comedy at shows. There are times you just watch a TV and you watch a particular funny guy in a particular movie. It's still comedy. And you can just get to your phone and not check out people that, you know.
One of the persons you saw Vision for, I just got confirmation that she wants to sow a seed now. Magbe?
Oh, yes!
Don't rush the seed.
Wala Anugba! Over! Oli, loro! Oli, oli,
calm down.
Irene, thank you for bringing back memories. I still remember my mother blowing the gizzard, you know, doing that to the gizzard before we cut it open. But I want to ask you, I mean, you've talked about how long it takes for prayers to be answered in the different parts of Lagos. I'm wondering, if I go to work and I pray on the island, will my prayers be answered in the time that the people who live on the island's prayers?
Exactly. It depends on which side you are going on the island, Mark. Very, very important. Very, very, please, your section of work, please, is very, very important. I believe that what we are going to do for you is that we are going to have intercession for you. Send out your prayer point to us. You get my point. So by the time you are going, before you get to work on the island, it's already answered. Now, if you're on the island, we give you things to do, it's already answered. And where you are staying to on the mainland, so if you are staying on the mainland, pray on the island at work, please. So that by the time you are going back home, it's already answered. That's the chemistry of answered prayers.
Okay, well, so what if the prayers have been answered? And then since she's going back, before the prayer now get home, traffic now hold the prayer.
That's another issue. It's a traffic issue. We now give a timetable answering process.
So what you're saying is that if she stays on the mainland and walks on the island, and then she prays on the island, and the answer comes quickly, she has to use that answer prayer on the island.
That's it. That's all. Have a mini house on the island as well, in case of a trap.
Right. Right, scam.
At this rate, let's go to... We'll, after the break, we'll just come back in just a moment. Stay with us. Welcome back. Well, what a session it's been. I mean, gentlemen have cracked us up so hard. I can't remember my last one. Took time out to go laugh this hard. So what are you guys doing after, I mean, how have the celebrations been? Are you continuing celebration today, tomorrow, going back to work next year?
Oh, you're continuing the celebration forever.
Well, my name is Forever, but that doesn't mean I have to rest. Because breakdown is real. It's really real. So I have some events. So the celebration is still on. But basically 2020 is another year. I have my comedy special again for next year. And then some other stuff coming up as well. Yeah.
It was, you know, Channels is very, very, very special to me. I was called from the mountain. I've been marathon. I'm praying for a lot of people. I'm not saying you inclusive, beautiful lady, everybody, Nigerian, you know, is a nation. So, I'm going back to the mountain again. And, you know, and this one is chronic.
Which floor? How many floors?
You know, you see, these are mountains they're powerful mountains. And when I want to take my bait on those, I do strenuous stuff. I take ordinary hot water. Muffin way. That's how you to break. I break with serious things.
You break it fast with ordinary hot water?
Yes. Wow. Then I bait also with ordinary water. I don't mix it. These are spiritual. I want something called the gigabyte of glory, the power charging your glory. Where is your destiny charger? Where is your life SIM card? You know, these are mysteries. You know, where is your memory card? Is it full? How do you format it? I'll be unveiling
these things are spiritual or technology.
You see, no, not at all. It's the spiritual angle. You get my point? There's some slang that came about. People don't know it's spiritual. My fault. Don't be afraid. These are deep things. You know, these are heavily powerful.
Wait, so I'm not feeling that I didn't come with you.
You have the spiritual chargers.
At this moment, I need to buy a new charger because 2020 is a great year. See, do you people say spiritual power bank? Get charger does not work.
No, see what I saw is that charger.
From the time now.
I'm saying it now that what's your charger doing inside traffic? Father Lord, take me to a stop.
But there was no traffic when I was coming.
What he's saying is that the charger that you used to charge because it measured gigabyte of glory.
Thank you. Forever have it. You see, you cannot sit beside the prophet and not receive the spirit of my Lord.
But don't shout that.
Gigabyte lasts forever.
Unlimited. Yes. I'm not talking for it. It's unlimited. I'm going to give for you.
But he's saying that.
Who took your SIM card? Them. Talo yo. See me on the mountain. You can't continue here.
Okay, the SIM card should see you all here.
Yeah, himself.
Okay, so what he's saying is that the charger that you need to charge your glory to get to the right gigabyte in 2020 is not with you yet. It's in traffic.
But from nowhere.
When he's going back to the mountain, he will pray
from now
and
again.
That charger will find its way to the shop.
That's it!
Are you the prophetic interpreter?
No! You cannot! Look at me!
I didn't understand what he said. I didn't understand what that revelation came in French.
No network on
revelation. No, revelation came in French. So our young Josué le Mavou Seletwe.
So you need a translator.
Maybe if he says it again. You know, when he say once have I spoken, twice have you heard. Yeah. Maybe if he's say it again.
I think he's getting to that time of day where we have
jacket, wow! I've gotten it.
Yeah.
He said in 2020.
That's it!
He told you about SIM card.
Aha!
That the SIM card is in a new jacket
Aha!
that you buy.
Aha!
Blue striped jacket.
Yes, sir.
So when you buy it, once you remove the nylon,
Aha!
Chuck your hand inside this bucket where the whole pocket is.
Prophetic.
SIM card.
Aha!
Full one. Uh-huh. So you have to go and cut it to the normal size.
Yes, sir.
And then you can start charging your glory for 2020.
That's all. I share it all.
You slap me.
But then
now.
I'm doing 3 days strength mission. Okay? 3 days. But then I'm hearing names here. Strength. Advert party program.
What kind of name?
I'm hearing names. Who is Chukudi? Okay. Who is Kola? Yes. Who is Kule?
Go to the
Taiwo. Yami. Who are you?
You have not heard Yomi. You have not heard Chris. You have not heard Ambrose.
Kola. You are a start bachelor. Can you just be sharing me? You've attended how many weddings? These are deep things. I'm stuck. Odipo.
Wait, Arole, wait.
Who is someone? Who is the governor? Let us stay. See me. Tell the governor. Uncle Jide.
They will soon close. Sam, before you round up, I need to say this. I got here alone. I met him here at the reception. So what this is what we're doing is it will end here. So if you're looking for who to hold.
No charger.
I don't have charger. I'm looking for auto. That's the man there. Just go to the mountain. You will see him there. I'm a young man with a purpose. 2020 is a great year for me. Don't hold me, please. Leave me alone. I have a young family that cannot be looking for their father. He's alone. Hold him.
All right, guys. Well, that's the show today. We thank you all for watching, gentlemen. I really am forever. Always a pleasure to have you both.
Thank you for having us.
Next week. I'm Chamberlain Uso.
I'm Ayo Makinde. Have a wonderful weekend.
And I'm Okwe Ogunyusa. Thank you for watching.